WYFF News 4, live local breaking news at 6.
Good evening. Welcome. I'm Michael Cogdell.
And I'm Carol Goldsmith. First tonight, we've said it for most nights this week, some of us could see severe weather tonight.
Again, let's get right to the man, Chief Meteorologist John Sesswich. John, what's going on now?
Well, you know, they're very isolated to scatter, just like over the last several nights, Carol and Michael, which is good news. So we're not talking about widespread severe thunderstorms. But let's take a look at live Super Doppler 4HD. A couple of cells that I want to talk about, and we'll zoom on into to both of them in particular. This one now moving into Oconee County. You got hammered a couple of nights ago, and now you're getting hammered again with a severe thunderstorm. It's moving through you folks in Westminster, just moving through Seneca, West Union. This thunderstorm is continuing to make its way off to the northeast at about 20 to 25 miles per hour. Then we'll head up here, and still this one cell now in extreme, looks like northeastern part of Rutherford County, and that thunderstorm's about ready to move into northern Cleveland County. That also is a hail producer, and maybe with gusts, wind gusts up to maybe 55 miles per hour. We'll keep you updated throughout the newscast. Now back to you, Michael.
We'll check back, John. Thank you. Spartanburg County deputies say a call from a hospital led to a filthy discovery and child cruelty charges against a couple. Their children are in protective custody tonight. News 4's John Eby is live and local at the Spartanburg County Sheriff's Office with more. John, the deputies say drugs are involved in this, right?
That's right. Let's say that's how this all got started. When Spartanburg Regional Medical Center called DSS after a pregnant mother of two tested positive for three kinds of illegal drugs. Now tonight, Crystal Ann Wooten and her husband Donnie Wooten are both charged with child cruelty. Deputies say Crystal is 31 weeks pregnant. She tested positive for opiates, amphetamines, and marijuana, but the drugs were just the beginning. When a DSS worker went to their house, she said she found dried puddles of urine all over the floor. She said there were patches of dirt or feces ground into the floor throughout the house. She said the couple's three-year-old girl was playing in a filthy bucket of water out on the front porch. Deputies took the girl and the Wooten's five-year-old son into protective custody.
And we see this neglect, unkept or unsanitary living conditions for children, and it's just something that we can't tolerate. Once we know about it, we owe it to the children to remove them from that type of environment.
Deputies have made no charges related to drug use in this case, but they said they haven't ruled it out yet. The Wootens have been released from jail on bond. John Eby, WYFF News 4, live in Spartanburg County.
Thank you, John. Police in Spartanburg say a safety seat saved the life of a girl who fell from a moving car. News 4's Mike McCormick is live and local from our Spartanburg newsroom tonight. Mike, how's she doing?
Well, Carol, police tell us she just had some scratches on her legs and that's all. And tonight, experts are hoping what happened to her doesn't happen again.
A baby has fallen out of a car.
That 911 call came in Thursday from the intersection of Converse and Henry Streets in Spartanburg.
They picked up the baby and pulled it to the sidewalk, and it's in its car seat, but she was screaming. I looked out my window and saw the baby upside down in the street.
Police say a grandmother was making a turn and didn't know that the two-year-old in the back seat had opened the door. The girl rolled out onto the road. Oncoming traffic stopped just in time. Police say the seat protected the girl, but had it been properly secured in the car, she never would have fallen out in the first place.
One of the largest injuries done to children is automobile accidents, and they're one of the most prevented.
Penny Shaw is with Spartanburg Regional's Safe Kids.
Buying it's not the only thing that is required. It does take some skill in actually installing it.
Lieutenant Nicholas Fortner is a certified car seat technician at the North Spartanburg Fire Department, where people come in 3 to 4 times a week asking for car seat help.
There's multiple types out there.
You need to read the owner's manual of the safety seat.
The car seats that you purchase may not necessarily work with the type of vehicle you got.
Do not buy a used car seat because you don't know if it's ever been in an automobile accident. So the seat that was used in this particular automobile accident needs to be replaced.
And if you would like to find a place that will help you with installation or at least check out the job you've already done, you can go to the Scene on 4 section of our website, WYFF4.com. Mike McCormick, WYFF News 4, live tonight in the Spartanburg newsroom.
Thank you. The Gaffney police tonight charge a woman with DUI and child endangerment. They say she tried to drive around barricades at a street festival where several people were walking and that she was driving drunk with her child in the car. Gaffney police arrested Teresa Maddox. Police say she tried to drive around those roadblocks on Limestone Street. After Maddox was stopped, police say she failed a field sobriety test. They say her blood alcohol level was nearly 3 times the legal limit. Her 10-year-old is now in the custody of family members. We're learning more tonight about the mother who was killed on Mother's Day. You may remember her son admits to pulling the trigger. Here's a picture of Kathy McEachern provided to us by the post office where she worked. Kathy's friend says she was planning on retiring and working full-time at the Hispanic ministry that she was involved with. And here's another picture of Kathy McEachern. She's the one standing in the very back in the turquoise dress. She was shot to death just hours after that photo was taken. The women were standing there on Mother's Day at the Hispanic ministry. The pastor there says Kathy stood up and gave her testimony the night she was killed.
She said that she loved her children very much, and she was very concerned about her children, and her desire was to see her children saved and to serve the Lord, and that if it took my death, I was willing to die in order for my children to be saved.
Her son, 17-year-old Joshua McEachern, is charged with her murder tonight. Greenville County deputies say he shot her in the face and nearly killed his older brother after firing on him. Joshua remains in jail tonight without bond.
Overcrowding at some Greenville County schools has school board members considering redrawing some of the lines that dictate which school a student attends. The biggest change would be in Simpsonville. A new elementary school is under construction there. About 1,200 students who currently attend Bell's Crossing, Malden, Bethel, Oakview, Rudolph Gordon, Simpsonville, and Woodland Elementary schools would be assigned to this school. Some students attending Woodland Elementary and Berea Middle School would also be reassigned. School officials say students who are reassigned can remain at their current school, but their parents will have to drive them. The changes would take effect at the start of the 2012-2013 school year. The school board is asking for public input and could reach a decision by the end of next month. The Reverend Billy Graham remains hospitalized tonight. Dr. Graham was admitted Wednesday morning to Mission Hospital in Asheville. He's undergoing treatment for pneumonia. Earlier this morning, doctors said Graham is in fair condition and that he had a comfortable night. Right now, there is no timetable on when he might be able to return home to Montreat.
Tonight, Boeing's union battle with the National Labor Relations Board over its South Carolina plant is now a political battle as well. Republicans want President Obama to ask the NLRB to withdraw its complaint. The National Labor Relations Board is trying to stop Boeing from moving a plane assembly line to South Carolina. The board accuses the company of relocating the line from Washington State to get back at union workers who've gone on strikes. The Boeing factory being built in North Charleston is a non-union plant. The White House says it won't get involved, adding it would be unprecedented for the president to influence the decisions of an independent regulatory agency with members he's appointed. But Boeing insists this rises to the level of a White House response.
Art, food, and fun for children. The Artisphere Festival is in full swing right now in downtown Greenville. Take a live look. Artisphere is rated as one of the top 20 arts festivals, and that's across the country. And it's not just about visual arts. There's also a performing arts stage with acts from across the country performing throughout the three-day event. There are also cooking demonstrations and a children's area. Festival goers are encouraged to park in city parking garages, keep your coolers and pets at home, but feel free to bring a blanket or lawn chair to relax around different venues. Artisphere spreads throughout downtown near Falls Park. It runs until 8 tonight, 10 to 8 on Saturday, Sunday from 11 to 6. There's no admission, but of course you'll have to pay for any art or food you want. Be sure to go to WYFF4.com for a schedule of the performances and the participating artists. You'll also find the event map that you can print.
The debate over prayer at school functions is a hot issue that's been going on for decades in this country, and right now the matter is getting plenty of attention in Lawrence County. It's all surrounding the upcoming graduation there. New at 6 tonight, this was Keisha Foster. It's live and local on the story from our Anderson newsroom. Keisha, good evening.
Good evening, Michael. Well, Lawrence School District 55's high school graduation is in 3 weeks, and this year the long-standing tradition of an official school prayer at the ceremony will end. That's because one of the seniors says the act of school-endorsed prayer is illegal.
On June 2nd, the 2011 senior class of Lawrence School District 55 will graduate, but with an air of controversy.
I have not had any negative backlash off of it. Everybody has said they wanted to sign the petition. I don't have to ask. They read, they write. It's that simple.
Prayer petitions like this one at Crenshaw Store are making rounds across the community. People are signing it to show support for an official school prayer at this year's commencement.
I think we ought to be able to pray anywhere we want to pray, anytime we want to pray. I mean, that's that young man's opinion. That's one person's opinion. And if the other children want to pray, that should be their privilege.
According to the Wisconsin-based Freedom From Religion Foundation, a member of the Lawrence High senior class contacted them.
Contacted us to let us know that there was a state church violation at his school and he needed help to correct it. And, you know, I'm still not altogether convinced that we're going to have a prayer-free commencement there.
After the organization sent letters of complaint to school district officials, the following decision was made by Superintendent Billy Strickland. Quote, "Our legal counsel has advised us that we should discontinue the practice of voting on whether to have an invocation delivered at the graduation ceremony, so we do not create a basis for a legal challenge," end quote.
Stated that the views expressed during student-led messages will not reflect the approval or disapproval of the school district. Keisha Foster, WYFF News 4, live in the Anderson Newsroom.
Now your live Super Doppler 4 HD weather forecast.
At least I have some good news in the fact that we're only looking at very, very isolated to scattered thunderstorms that are quite strong. Just really a couple of them, but we could see more of them continue to develop across the Western Carolinas and northeastern Georgia, and any one of them could briefly become severe, producing large hail and damaging winds. In fact, this cell did produce some large hail and some damaging winds back in through parts of Stevens County, and as it continues to make its way through Oconee County, now it's making its way right over Lake Kiwi, and eventually it's going to get into Pickens County. We also have another cell developing here very close to Lake Hartwell, probably right on top of Lake Hartwell, and now beginning to move into Anderson County. That one may become severe. We'll have to watch that closely. And we still have this cell that's now extreme northeastern part of Rutherford County that's quite strong and moving into extreme northwestern part of Cleveland County. Otherwise, everything's looking pretty good. We'll zoom on in, take a closer look at this cell. Good news is it's starting to weaken a little bit. Still producing some hail here right over Lake Kiwi, it looks like, and here's Salem, and it's about ready to move into Pickens County. It's moving east-northeast bound, so it may make its way right into you folks in Liberty. There's a chance that this thundershower may go right over Pickens here early this evening, over the next half hour or so, and then that'll be it for the rest of tonight. It probably will be the case. Now, we have a couple of watch boxes out. This is a severe thunderstorm watch now for northern Georgia, western North Carolina until 7 o'clock this evening. And then we have this other severe thunderstorm watch, this box here, which includes Greenville, Spartanburg, Anderson, all the way over to Charlotte through the Piedmont and foothills of North Carolina. This is until 11 o'clock this evening. So basically, the entire viewing area is under some sort of watch, whether it goes until 7 or 11 o'clock. Now, 85 right now in Greenville, 92 in Augusta, 87 in Hilton Head, 85 in Macon. Oh, it's warm air ahead of this system that's coming in. Very slow-moving cold front coming in from the west, and it's not going to get here until it's going to pass by us, not until tomorrow during the day. 77 right now in Asheville, 64 degrees cool down in Franklin behind the front, 70 in Gainesville, 80 in Athens. It's 86 in Greenwood, 90 right now in Columbia, and high humidity levels through this area, 82 degrees currently in Charlotte. Nationally, so there's our two severe thunderstorm watch boxes. Then we have the one back here in northern Mississippi, western part of Tennessee, and it does include Memphis, like they see need more severe weather, and they're getting severe weather moving through right now with large hail and damaging winds, let alone the flooding problems along the Mississippi River. And then we're talking about some showers and some thunderstorms moving through Chicago, where it's 54 degrees. So a little bit cooler weather behind the front, as you can see. Much cooler in Kansas City at 52, 54 in Minneapolis, 62 in Denver. Remember, yesterday in Denver, they had a rain-snow mix as that cold front passed by them yesterday. Upper-level lows here. It's going to spin on in and produce some showers for us, especially as we get into early next week. So here's our forecast then for tonight. Low 56 in the mountains, scattered showers and strong thunderstorms around the area, isolated strong thunderstorms, humid conditions in the upstate, so not everybody's going to get wet. Then we could see maybe a shower late tonight as the front gets a little bit closer to us and some patchy fog. Front moves in very slowly from the west, which means a pretty good chance of showers and thunderstorms around the area, especially in the afternoon. High 80 in the upstate, 72 in the mountains, and once again tomorrow, there is the threat that any of these thunderstorms could produce large hail and damaging winds. We'll keep you updated. And a threat for severe thunderstorms will continue even into tomorrow evening. Front passes by. We become a little bit more stable and not too bad on Sunday now with partly cloudy skies in the upstate and only a slight chance of a stray rain shower, especially in the afternoon. High 78. Upper 60s in the mountains, a little bit cooler with the best chance of scattered rain showers. And then all of us getting in on the action with scattered showers Monday and Tuesday of next week. We finally dry out, but not until the end of next week. It's a very slow storm system, to say the least.
John. A little brisk there for a while.
A little brisk, kinda. Yeah, absolutely.
John, thank you.